Ciao friends! In this video, I want to show you how to first understand and then solve a problem that you are likely to face if you write perfectly legit code in Power BI, but in the code you are changing the filter context over a column that happens to be sorted by another column. We will first look at the problem, then we will need to understand it. That requires some digging, so we will need to investigate on it, look at the queries generated by Power BI in order to understand exactly what originates the problem. Once the scenario will be clear, fixing it is really simple. But the real interesting part is understanding from where the problem comes from. Sounds interesting? Follow me. The first step is understanding the scenario and looking at the problem. In this report, I have a slicer by year and a matrix that is slicing by month name and showing the sales amount. Now, I want to compute the percentage of the sales in 1 month against the grand total of the sales. That requires computing a numerator and a denominator. The numerator is just the sales amount, and the denominator need to be the grand total. Now, I have already written the code. And you see that I'm doing divide sales amount, that is this number in the filter context of each individual cell. And at the denominator, I'm using calculate, again, sales amount, but using all date month name. What does all do? All removes the filter on the month name and it keeps the filter on the year. So by doing that, it retrieves the grand total, and the result, formatted as a percentage, should be the correct value. Unfortunately, if I use this measure and I drop it in my report, it shows 100%, which is just wrong. Besides, it's interesting to note that the formula by itself works just fine. If I look at the same report in Excel, this is an Excel file connected with the same Power BI file, and I'm using the same month names, the same filter, the same values, and most important, here I have the same measure, it is working just fine. It is computing the correct percentage. So why is that I have a measure that works in Excel and it does not work in the latest version of the DAX engine in Power BI? That is preposterous. So we need to understand exactly where the problem is. In order to do that, we will first need to focus on where the problem is. Remember, it works in Excel, it does not work in Power BI, so the problem is not in the DAX code. But it is likely that we are not taking into account the specific way Power BI runs the query against my model. To understand that, we will look at exactly the query generated by Power BI to retrieve information that populate my matrix, and there we will find the problem. Let's do that together. The first thing that we need to do is grab the query generated by Power BI in order to populate our matrix. So to do that, we go to View, enable the Performance Analyzer, we start recording, and then we refresh the visuals. We have our matrix. I can now copy the query and paste it in DAX Studio. So I already have DAX Studio open, and this is the query generated by Power BI. I never look at queries as they are generated by Power BI. I always do some makeup in order to make them easier to read. So let's do that together. We have this filter that I prefer to see there. Then we can get rid of subtotals, because I'm not interested in looking at individual subtotals. The problem is in the cells of the matrix, not in the subtotal. And I also have this top n. All the queries in Power BI always have a top n, but I'm not interested in looking at that. I just want to evaluate the original query. And finally, I have removed the subtotal column, so I also need to get rid of it. Now I can format my code and start to reason on top of it. First of all, let's see the result. The result contains the month name, the month number, the sales amount, and the percentage over the months, which is always 1, that is 100%. Now, if you remember the matrix, let's look at it again, getting rid of the performance analyzer. We have the month name, the sales amount, and the percentage over the month. Whereas in the same result returned by the query in DAX Studio, we have the month name, the sales amount, the percentage, but we also have the month number, which is explicitly requested here because summarize column is grouping by month name and month number. The reason for this is because in the order by, it requires to order by month number and month name. And this is the same order that will be kept in the matrix. You can see it here. It is sorting January, February, March, and not using alphabetical sorting. It is doing that because the month name is sorted by month number. We can look at that. If we search for the month name under the sort by column, you see that the month name is sorted by month number. Now, whenever you have a column that is sorted by another column, the query generated by Power BI contains not only the column you are querying, but also the column that is needed to do the order by. And this creates a problem in the code. Let's understand it a bit better. When we run this query, we evaluate the percentage over month. So it is in sales. Let me add it to the report. We get rid of it, and I want to see the code of percentage over month, which is divide sales amount by calculate sales amount all date month. Now, this all gets rid of the filter on the month name, which is present in the filter context because summarize column is grouping by month name. But summarize column is also grouping by month number, and we are not removing that filter. So the final filter context that computes the denominator will not have a filter on the month name, but will still have a filter on the month number. And because there is a one-to-one relationship between the values in the two columns, removing the filter only from the month name does not change the actual number computed by sales amount. To fix it, what we need to do is get rid of the filter from the month name and from the month number. So we need to add the date, month number to the all statement in order to get rid of both filters. If I run the query now, you see that the percentage is now 7%, 7%, 8%. So by removing the filter from both columns, now I have the code that works fine. This is fine. I now have my measure. Let me copy, go back to Power BI and change the code here. I put it in place, hit enter, and suddenly my measure is working just fine. Now it is computing the correct percentage. This happens every time you have a column that is sorted by another column. It happens in Power BI and not in Excel because Excel uses MDX, and MDX is not subject to the same behavior. MDX uses different techniques that do not require requesting also the month number if you want to sort the month name by month number. Now, scenarios like these are very simple to solve once you understand the problem. For new buyers or people who are not used to this peculiar behavior of Power BI, it might seem strange because the code is just fine, but it's the way the query is executed that creates the problem. The thing is, once you get used to debug the things the right way, Power BI shares no secret. You can always look at the code using the performance analyzer and understand exactly what is happening. Enjoy DAX!